Welcome to my session about master images code via Azure DevOps Pipeline. My name is Patrick van der Born. I'm an independent consultant based in the Netherlands. I'm also very proud to be a Citrix technology professional. I'm also a member of the GPU Nerds, which is Team RGE. And I'm also a member of GoEUC, where I do some performance investigations, but also automating their lab with everything as code. If you have any questions after this session, you can reach out to me via email, Twitter, LinkedIn, read my blog, or just view my code on GitHub. A little bit of an agenda for today. First, I will give you some context about my project and why I started with Images Code with Packer and created the framework. Then we will dig into Packer, and then we will dig into the layered framework I've created. At the end of the session, there will be a demo of creating an image via Azure DevOps pipelines. So if you just look where I come from, is that my previous world of image automation was mainly WDS with MDT, Ivanti Automation, and PowerShell scripting. This is what I did for years, starting with Windows 2000 back in the days, automating the installation of that. If I look at the project which I'm now working on, is that it's mandatory for us to define everything in code. So basically, we've created three main pillars in our project. One is infrastructure as code, and we're using HashiCorp Terraform for that. And we used HashiCorp Terraform to deploy our main infrastructure. For example, our Citrix Cloud connectors, our Azure NetApp files, where our FSLogix containers are stored, and our networking, for example. We also defined a pillar called images code, and we're using HashiCorp Packer for this. And basically, we're describing images as code for VMware vSphere, Microsoft Azure, and in the future for Amazon AWS. The third pillar we've created within our project is desktop as code. And basically, we're describing our Citrix Cloud configuration and our Citrix Virtual Apps and Desktop Services configuration in code. This session is only focused on images code, which is one pillar within our project. Let's start with the next topic. So basically, images code with Packer. If you're very enthusiastic after this session, you can go to packer.io, download the latest version of Packer, and start using it on your virtual machine right away. So please hold on for more details. So when we started this project, we did an application selection about how to deploy our images to Azure. And since we start using Azure, we investigated HashiCorp Packer and the Azure Image Builder. So basically, we've chosen to use Packer because Packer has a multi-platform support with their builders. As you remember from the first slide, for us, it's mandatory to deploy our images on Azure, AWS, and vSphere. If you, on the other hand, look to the Azure Image Builder, it has a vendor lock-in because you can deploy your images on Azure only. Both tools are like images code. You can save it in a repository, and HashiCorp Packer is very simple. The first time I started to create an image, it took me about 1.5 hours to deploy my first image. If you look at the Azure Image Builder, it's also very simple, but it's more like an abstraction layer around Packer. It is an umbrella and it uses Packer under the hood. So mainly I think like, hey, if something is that simple, like HashiCorp Packer, why is the abstraction layer more simple? Maybe it's harder to use the Azure Image Builder. If you look at HashiCorp Packer, you need to get familiar with some terminology. So the first one, it's a Packer Builder. And a Packer Builder is a temporary virtual machine which actually builds the image and is destroyed when the actual image is captured from the builder. If we look at the platforms where you can build images, You see on the left-hand side lots of common used platforms. For example, Azure, Google Cloud, even Nutanix, VirtualBox, or if you want to try it on your local machine, you can install Hyper-V and run Packer locally. On the right-hand side, you see a lot of platforms I don't know, but it's also supported to create your images over there. And since this is a Citrix event, there's also a community-supported builder to deploy your images on Citrix Hypervisor. So that's awesome. You can also use this for your Citrix environment. On the other hand, you will read a lot about provisioners when using Packer. And a provisioner installs and configures the software on the builder. It's basically like a task sequence, what we doing for years, for example, in MDT or SCCM. And if you look at the Windows type of provisioners, you can use a file-based, which actually up and downloads a file to the provisioner or to the builder. And you can also use Windows PowerShell to execute PowerShell scripts. You can use Windows Shell to execute command line scripts. And if you need a reboot within the task sequence, you can use Windows Restart. Please keep in mind that you can also use Packer to build your Linux VDAs. If you like to use more like a desired state configuration, you can also use, for example, Ansible and give Packer an Ansible playbook, and Packer will just execute the Ansible playbook for you. But if you like more like Chef, Puppets, or Salt, then that's more your case. You can also use that for the build of your Packer image. If you look to the example with the built-in provisioners for Windows, this is a very easy example of installing three applications like FSLogix, Office 365, and a Teams machine-wide installer. What you can also do is when executing a PowerShell script is passing environment variables to the Packer builder. So the environment variables become available on the Packer builder itself. You can also specify an execution context by specifying a username and a password, and Packer will run the PowerShell script in that particular context. If we look more at the pipeline perspective, we can use pipeline variables to map them to environment variables, so the pipeline variables come available during the Packer build. And the end result in this case on Azure, it's a managed image, for example, an image in your shared image gallery, or just a VHD on your storage account, which you can use for machine creation services. The next section is about images code installation layers, which is a little bit of a PowerShell framework I've created for Packer. So if you look at Packer, they have it about Packer templates. And the Packer template is an image description of about what to build. And I was thinking like a template image description. Where did I hear the image template? Yeah, where I heard that before. So if I did a lot of app layering projects, and within Citrix app layering, they created a very handy structure of structuring and reusing the application layers again. So I was thinking like, hey, can I use this methodology to reuse my installation scripts, for example? So what we basically did, we also defined some layers when starting with the 00 PS modules layer. And this is the only layer where we implement our intelligence for our installation framework. The other layers are just installation scripts without intelligence, but reference to the PowerShell modules, but separating different type of order. So for example, first all the scripts of the OS layers are executed by installing, for example, GPU drivers and language packs. And then the scripts of the next layer, in this case, the platform layers, is installed. So for example, the Citrix VDA and VMware tools. And at the end, the ceiling layer with BizEv and Citrix Optimizer is executed. One tip here, add an agents layer in it because, for example, we experienced a longer installation time while installing lots of checking agents, for example, DAP, DLP. So if we take this layered approach towards a visual of our repository, so on the left-hand side, you see our Azure DevOps repository. And we've got one folder called Packer Templates. And this is where we define our Packer Image Templates files. And if you look at the Packer Install folder, we've created folders with all the different layers that we have. So basically, as I said, our scripting intelligence is in the PS modules, which is installed on the Packer Builder at first. And then we specify, and we can just copy the template and installation script installing AvisLogix, for instance, and reusing the scripting intelligence of the PS modules. And that script, for example, for the AvisLogix, can be reused in multiple Packer templates. So for example, in the EU or in OC. So if I update the code of the AvisLogix installation, then it's updated in all my layers. So basically, you can have a click and collect image over here. If we have a little sneak peek to the template itself, it's just specifying only the executable or MSI name with all the silent install parameters or the MSI properties, and then reference to our install application function, which is in the PS modules. So basically, now it's time for a little bit of a demo. Welcome to my demo of creating a Citrix master image with Packer via Azure DevOps pipelines. So at first we want to connect our Azure repository to our local Visual Studio Code so we can edit files. When you go to Azure DevOps, you can click your project. So in my case, this is Born IT CICD Desktop. Within here, you can go to repositories and files. And here you can find the repository of our images code. And in this repository, all the files are stored describing our image. So for example, the Packer template or the installation script or the YAML files for the pipeline run. So if I want to edit this in Visual Studio Code, I just click clone and clone in VS Code, open, and Visual Studio Code will ask me, I really want to open this URL. I said, okay. Select a location where the repository is stored locally, and Visual Studio Code will use Git to clone the repository to my local storage. So when I press open, I can see the files in Visual Studio. So that's very easy. Let's first start investigate the Packer templates, which are actually my image description. So within the Packer templates, I define two templates, Win10 multi-user for Azure and Windows Server 2019 for vSphere. So if you look at the files which are in the template, there are actually three HEL files. And HEL stands for HashiCorp language, and those files are stitched together when doing a Packer build. So let's first dig into the variables file. So in the variables file, I declared all the different variables used by the Packer template. So for example, the Azure AD application key and the Azure application ID, which is actually connected to my Azure tenant. I can mark some type of streams as sensitive by specifying sensitive is true. And when I specify the sensitive is true, the strings are not logged. So they're just replaced by stars. So the application key, for example, is not exposed in a log. If we look at the Packer template itself, you see these two sections here. One is source, which is actually the description of our Packer builder, and build. This is actually the task sequence of provisioners, which will in the end be our master image. So if we look to the source, so this is the Packer builder, I specified here Azure ARM. So if we look to the vSphere builder, I can specify, for example, here vSphere ISO to specify a vSphere build via an ISO file. As you can see here, different parameters are needed per builder type. So in this case, I need to define the cluster where my builder VM is deployed. And if I look to Azure, I need to define the resource group where my builder VM is deployed, for example. When building a Packer image on Azure, it's very important not using a public IP. So if you enable this, a public IP will be attached to the builder VM, and yeah, you can publicly connect to Windows Remote Management. And I think you don't want that. And as you can see here, all the parameters are linked to a variable. So in this case, it's the AZ VM image offer. Those variables are specified in the PKR VARs file. So for example, for this image, an Azure virtual machine size of B2MS is deployed in West Europe. If we look at the build, then we see here that it's using the builder on Azure, like the source, this is what we say seen above, Azure ARM, Windows 10 multi-user Born IT AZ. This is the label over here. When starting the build, Packer will first execute this provisioner. This is just an inline PowerShell script installing Chocolaty, then installing 7-zip via Chocolaty, Notepad++, and build a manifest file. So we can use this, for example, as an artifact, so we know where the VHD is stored after the build. In my build, I specified the most variables for my builder in a pipeline. So for my pipelines, I specified a Packer builder VARs file. And here I specified all the information used by the Packer build. So for example, my subscription ID, application ID, my builder temporary resource group name, which will be actually RG Packer build, and when the build started with the build number as a postfix, and some variables are retrieved from the key vault. So I specify them here as retrieved from the key vault so that I do not have to specify this in code and store this on my repository. When you look at the Packer job and we look at the Packer build, you see here that I specify during the build all the different parameters from the pipeline to a variable which we declared in Packer. So for example, the Azure AD application ID, this is the Packer variable, and this is my pipeline variable. And I also uses the PKR VARs HCL file of the template as an input. So this was the file where we specified, for example, in which location the builder VM is built, or what type of marketplace image is used. This was this file. So okay, let's deploy this image to Azure. To deploy this image on Azure, we go back to Azure DevOps. And since we specified not using a public IP for our builder, it's mandatory to use a self-hosted Azure DevOps agent, since we need to have a network connection to the private IP of the builder VM. And the public Azure DevOps agents from Microsoft cannot connect to your private IP addresses. So when you go to project settings, agent pools, we see an agent pool here, which is Windows Azure MPN, which is hosting my Microsoft Partner Network subscription. And if we look to the agent, I just installed it on my WVD host, session host, and it's up to date and it's online. So I can use this for my pipeline run. When you want to run a pipeline, we just go to pipelines. We see here Azure Windows 10 multi-user Born IT Azure, and I simply press run pipeline. So these are the parameters which are specified on the YAML pipeline. And yeah, these are correct, so I can just hit run. Now the pipeline is starting, and you see it's a multi-stage pipeline. So the first step is to actually create the image, and the second step is to copy it to the right location. And now the build is started, and I will actually go to the point that it starts creating the image. Okay, the actually build is started, as you can see here. Here is the output and the logging of the Windows 10 multi-user Azure Packer built immutable image. So as you can see here is that a temporary resource group is created called RG Packer build Windows 10 with the build number. So you can see here the build number, and which is actually the build number of the run. The location is West Europe, and it's now creating temporary resources in Azure. So let's switch to Azure. So if we go to resource groups, we're seeing the same resource group here. As you can see, Packer created temporary resources in the temporary resource group. You can identify them with the prefix of PKR. And the rest of the names are generated by Packer. So everyone, the PKR virtual machine will have a different name. So it generates a virtual machine with a corresponding network card and a key vault. And in the key vault, a certificate is stored to connect securely to Windows Remote Management. Packer will delete those resources when it's done with the Packer run. So it's still creating an image. And as you can see here, it's installed Chocolaty. And it's now installing Notepad++ and 7-Zip. So it's downloading 7-Zip and installing it to the image, as you can see here. So the Packer build has finished. It took about 13 minutes to build the entire image. As you can see here at the end, the Packer builder is shut down and it's deleted from Azure. At first it captured the VHD from the builder VM. So if we go back to Azure and we go back to resource groups, we can refresh here. And we're seeing here that the default the temporary resource group is removed. If we look to our images in our containers, images, I see here the most recent image, which is Windows 10 multi-user Born ID Azure, and it's the 18th build of the image. So these images can be deployed to our virtual machines in Azure with Citrix Machine Creation Services. So we now deployed our image on Azure, and if I run the pipeline for vSphere, it will actually do the same process, only then on vSphere. Like, it's now giving us the output on vSphere, and it created a VM called Packer with the Packer run number in it. And when this Packer build is done, you can use a snapshot of this image to deploy this with Citrix Machine Creation Services, or maybe you want to make a provisioning service image of this, so you can deploy it with provisioning services. So if we now just wrap everything up, you've seen is that on the left hand side you see the Azure repository, and the first step by the pipeline is download the complete repository to a self-hosted Azure DevOps agent. The second step is that the Azure DevOps agent installs Packer on it and then starts Packer on the DevOps agent and use the template you've specified. The next step is that Packer will create a temporary builder VM, so in this case on Azure. And when the temporary builder VM becomes available, it will start provisioning PowerShell scripts via Windows Remote Management. So basically uploads the scripts and execute it on the Packer builder. You can use installation executables or MSIs by putting them on Azure FileShare, for example. But you can also use Evergreen, Chocolaty or Winget to always get the latest and greatest application. We do that, for example, while installing Visual Studio Code. When the entire build is done, Packer will grab the disk as a golden image and place this on your shared image gallery. So thank you for attending my session.